Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you. I warmly welcome you to the 9th Trade Award Ceremony of Pakistan-France Business Alliance, in short, PFBA. I especially thank the Ambassador of France, His Excellency Philippe Thiebaud, for gracing the occasion as the chief guest. I'm also grateful to Mr. Pierre Lignon, Regional Director, UB France, the Agency for International Development of French Businesses, who has come all the way from New Delhi to be with us this evening. I'm convinced the award ceremony will enable Mr. Lignon to appreciate the dynamism of the Pakistani companies working with French partners and the efforts that PFBA is putting in for promoting the bilateral economic relations. I'm hoping Mr. Lignon will pass on the message to UB France head office in Paris that Pakistan in general, and Karachi in particular, deserves attention commensurate with their economic potential. This annual feature of our activities has now become a much awaited event, not only by the eventual award winners and PFBA members, but by the business circles in general. Excellency, I may be repeating myself, but for the benefit of those who are here for the first time, PFBA is the only bilateral forum which every year acknowledges and honors the performance of the leading exporters and importers to and from France through the Trade Performance Award Ceremony. France is the leading business partner of Pakistan, next only to Germany in the European Union. The annual bilateral trade volume between our two countries has, for the past 2 years, exceeded 1 billion euros. Despite the steep rise of the euro, the demand for French goods has been increasing, not only in sectors such as perfumery and cosmetics, chemicals and pharmaceutical goods, but also in electrical equipments, metallurgy, etc. It needs to be underlined that Pakistan exports to France, which are dominated by textile and leather, have also been increasing, and the balance of bilateral trade remains in favor of Pakistan. It is likely to increase even further as the European Union restrictions on fisheries imports from Pakistan have been lifted. It may surprise many, but since the last 2 to 3 years, there has been increased interest on the part of French companies to invest in Pakistan. After L'Oréal, which has become a success story of sorts in Pakistan, Hyperstar with its hypermarket in Dolmen Mall of Karachi, after the one in Lahore, has become another household name synonymous of excellence in terms of variety and quality of goods offered as well as customer care. We can go on with Advance Pakistan, subsidiary of Horus Finance France, which has recently opened the second branch of its microfinance bank in one of the low-income localities of Karachi. Ipsos, the European number one and world number two in commercial and opinion polls, and without forgetting Mazars, which in a very short time has positioned itself as one of the leading business consultancy firms in Pakistan. Danone, the leading French dairy products company, is also present in Pakistan with its baby milk, and it is likely to diversify its product range and enhance its commitments here. I wish to emphasize that although individual member companies of PFBA have been scaling new heights in their exchanges with France, more institutional efforts need to be made on the part of PFBA to streamline the process of two-way information for Pakistani companies desirous of identifying business opportunities in France and vice versa for French companies. We need to go a step beyond the concept of business forum to that of a bilateral chamber of commerce, providing useful real-time assistance to the companies of both the countries regarding all aspects from identification of partners to legal and regulatory guidance to helping them participate in exhibitions and taking appointments with the desired interlocutors. To this end, I'm very pleased to announce that PFBA has recently set up a business support office headed by Mr. Hidayat Hussain, former head of the economic department in Karachi, to provide these services to the companies of both the countries. PFBA will henceforth collaborate closely with the regional office of the Agency for International Development of French Businesses based in Delhi to promote contacts between Pakistani and French companies and disseminate information to the Pakistani companies regarding trade exhibitions, not only in France, but also in India, where French companies participate. In 2007 and 2008, I led business delegations to France to interact with the chambers of commerce in Paris, Lyon, and Lille. After 2008, there has been no delegation to France on account of circumstances beyond our control. We intend reviving this part of our activity and re-establish contacts with the chambers of commerce in France. This will specially help those Pakistani companies which wish to go beyond the traditional textile leather mix and diversify Pakistani exports. Excellency, PFBA is pretty well positioned throughout Pakistan. We have about 184 members stretching from Karachi right up to Peshawar. My concern has been, Excellency, that the capital chapter based in Islamabad has not done well, and the individuals we nominated have fallen short of my expectations. As a consequence, Excellency, your executive committee has decided to appoint a new vice president for the capital chapter, Mr. Shaukatullah Khan Bangish. Where are you, Mr. Bangish? Are you around?
Yes, sir.
Well done. Here. Mr. Bangish is based in Islamabad, and I hope that the amount of money that he has, he will be able to project PFBA financially more strongly than hitherto before. I wish to thank the sponsors who have contributed generously in making today's event a memorable one. The French Consul General, Mr. Christian Ramage, for his personal involvement. Excellency, you are there. For his personal involvement and a generous supply of the elixir of life, commonly known in the English language as wine. Mr. Riaz Siddiqui of Infotel Pakistan, Mr. Qasim Zaheer of Total Oil, Mr. Zia Shams of Nutritia Pakistan, L'Oreal Pakistan, Emirates Airlines, who have given a business class ticket Karachi, Paris, Karachi via Dubai. Thank you. Mr. Abdul Basit of Grandparent Poultry. And finally, my sincere thanks to my good friend, Mr. Yunus Billu of Sindh Medical for his generous contributions as always. Excellency, Mr. Billu is a strong devotee of Pakistan-France Business Alliance, and I can count on him for his support. I also wish to thank a self-motivated, courageous, oozing with life, and vibrant, a young lady, Miss Yasmin Haider, CEO of New World Concepts, for organizing this evening's event. I don't know, I think she's been very helpful, but we've also been disturbed, but because we were not in control, she was in control. That was the difference. My sincere thanks to the steering committee for their valuable suggestions, as always, in putting together this event. The steering committee was made up of Mr. Saeed Allawala, Mr. Anis Khan, and Ms. Sadia Khan. Sadly, none of them are here tonight. Mr. Saeed Allawala, my right-hand man, who's the senior vice president of PFBA, his cousin expired this afternoon, so he's not here. The Duchess, Ms. Sadia Khan, she's traveling. And Mr. Anis Khan, I think he's incapacitated. I also wish to thank my team of the PFBA Secretariat who have burnt the midnight oil for this event. The team consists of Ms. Sabah Hussain, Mr. Shahid Zia, and Mr. Rahmat Noor. After dinner, ladies and gentlemen, you will be entertained to an extraordinary combination of music and comedy. And I assure you that you will thoroughly enjoy the evening of laughter, which we so badly need. Our main performer is a talented lady who is multilingual. I won't expand on her because she's going to do, let this be a surprise. She is a wonderful person. I warmly congratulate all award-winning companies. And once again, thank His Excellency the Ambassador of France for gracing this ceremony, as well as all the distinguished guests for being here tonight. Thank you.